Tomorrow, people across the Northern Hemisphere are going to be right in the path of what scientists are calling the Ring of Fire. We're not going to actually be able to see it in Indiana, but
we may be able to see what's called a partial solar eclipse around 6:16 a.m. tomorrow. Sometimes when the moon orbits Earth, it moves between the sun and the Earth. And when that happens, the moon will block out the light of the sun from actually reaching us on Earth. That's what an eclipse of the sun, or solar eclipse, is. According to NASA, there are three main types of solar eclipses. There's the total solar eclipse. This is when the Earth, Moon, and Sun are in a direct line. This is the type of eclipse when the sky gets really dark, like it's nighttime. Then you've got the partial solar eclipse. That happens when the Sun, Moon, and Earth aren't in exact alignment, so it looks like a chunk of the sun has actually been taken out. Then there's the third type of eclipse. It's called the annular eclipse, and that's when the moon covers the sun's center, leaving the sun's visible outer edge to form that ring of fire. And that's what parts of the Northern Hemisphere are gonna see on Thursday.
But what's really interesting about solar eclipses is that what type of eclipse you're seeing changes based on your location in the world. So on Thursday, people in Canada are gonna be able to see that annular solar eclipse, that's that ring of fire, but people living in cities like Toronto or New York or Philly are only gonna see a partial solar eclipse. As the sun rises, they're gonna see that missing chunk out of the sun. It's gonna be really cool, and if you want more information on this eclipse, you can head to WTHR.com to find out more.